Hey, what is up, you guys, and welcome to this episode of Eddie's Customs and Restorations.
So aside from the cap and rotor back there being corroded, another source of you having a no spark condition is actually this coil right here. I went ahead and unplugged a lot of this because I was about to replace it all, about to replace the coil. So let me show you a sign that you'll have on this coil that is a clear indication that it's failing. See if you can see the back right here. Let me see. Right there, you could see where the spark is basically starting to come out of that coil. It's starting to ground out, and it's starting to ground out right here at this piece right here at that square. Let me show you on the new one.
See, this is on the new one right here. You should be able to see basically like an air gap. You see that? You can see an air gap between this metal housing right here, which is basically the grounding area of this coil. And you should see that air gap. Once it's starting to bridge and jump, it's basically grounding itself out, causing this coil to fail intermittently. So when you purchase your new coil, it's gonna come with a little bit of hardware. This hardware right here is because this coil is riveted on. So you see these bottom holes down here? Well, on that plate that is on the truck, right down there, that back there, you cannot unscrew that. There's a pin right there, and then there's gonna be another one matching on the other side. You can't remove that just by simply unscrewing it. You're gonna have to grind that off. So once you grind it off, the coil's gonna pop off, and then you're gonna place this coil on there, and you're gonna use these screws. You see there's screws in there, and you're gonna put those little nuts, and that's how you're gonna hold your coil onto that bracket that's right there. Now I'm really low on battery, guys, but basically you gotta remove that nut right there, and then there's another nut that's gonna be over here. Once that bracket comes off, there's gonna be two more nuts under there. See, I can move that one, and I had already removed it. See down there, I removed that other one. All right, so I had to leave my phone charging for a bit, but I'm gonna walk you through all the steps on how to replace this coil, basically showing you a couple of images, but this is the new coil on here, and I'll show you what you gotta do in order to get it onto this bracket. So this is that bracket right here. You see the two bolt holes down there. Those basically mount at those shiny spots right there, that one and that one as well. And so that top bracket that I was talking about that you had to remove is this one. Okay, that little bracket right here, you have to remove that first, or at least try to get out of the way. In my case, that one right there, that screw that bolts on to the intake, ended up stopping right there, and I had to just like pivot it out of the way. So I'm gonna have to, you know, get that bottom half of the screw, get it with like some vice grips or something right now without damaging the threads, and take the top nut off, and then clean up those threads, and that way I can, you know, go back on there the proper way. So you got to put that stud in first to the intake, and then just leave the threaded stud up top, and then put your bracket on top of that. But anyhow, the question here, hopefully that doesn't happen to you. 9 times out of 10 it shouldn't, but you know, I went at it with an impact, and yeah, that happened. Anyhow, these are the two locations of where the mounting bolts are for the bracket that is for this guy right here for the whole coil. So let me show you a couple of photos showing you as to how to mount this guy on here, or what I did to get the old one off anyways. Now, in the event that you don't feel that your coil is bad, another culprit of bad spark or weak spark can be your cap or your cap and rotor, which are located back there. To remove this piece so you can check it out and inspect it, you're gonna first wanna remove your spark plug wires, okay? And one way to keep these in the correct orientation, that way you don't get them mixed up, See how there's a little clip back there? It holds all four wires together. Make sure that all four wires are in the exact order that they are located on the cap over there, and just simply unplug them and they all stay in the same order. And I did the same on this side over here. You know, that's how they go plugged in over there. Of course, I already took them off prior to starting this section of the video. I know that there's other videos on this on YouTube, so I wasn't gonna do it, but I want to basically catch on camera what I find under this and just show you guys and show you my experience here. So let me finish taking this off. I got two screws right there. You want to make sure you take your spark plug wires off first, because they are going to be on there pretty snug, and you don't want the cap being all loose as you're taking these off. So see, you got a little Torx head screw right there. I believe it's a Torx 15. I can't remember off the top of my head right now, but it's like a Torx 15 or so. But before you strip that bolt or that little screw, try on the Torx 15 and just make sure that it's good and snug on there. If it's not, just step up a size, you know, Torx 20 or something like that. So you got that screw right there, and then you got another one back there. All right, so let me finish taking those off right quick. Okay, so I went ahead and left them on there. Let me show you what I mean by that. Well, I left the main coil wire in place right here. It was just much easier to get to when I took it off from the coil over here. Sorry, getting a little camera shy here. So I left these screws in place right there, and that way it just helps from losing them. But let me come over here. Okay, so I didn't want to lose my screws there, but look at the bottom of this. Okay, look at all those little pegs on there, and they're all pretty much worn away. Okay, and what happens here is the fact that they're all worn away is you're gonna increase the gap that the spark has to travel from the rotor to this little peg right here. Okay, and another thing is right here, it's completely flat. There should be a little deal there. Let me show you on the new cap. The new cap is right here. See, you got perfect little cylinders right here. The little pegs are completely brand new. There's no gap that it's gonna have to fill, and you got that little deal right there that I was talking about. Makes contact with the contact point on the rotor. Anyhow, with the coil replaced and this cap, is gonna completely improve the drivability of this truck. Now, it's due for some spark plugs as well, but just in these two changes alone, very inexpensive. So I'll go ahead and post some Amazon affiliate links of where you can get a cap and a new coil for these 88 through 98 Chevy or GMC pickup trucks. I believe this also applies to the vans or the Astro vans. I'm not 100% sure, but for sure on the Chevys and the GMCs. Okay, we got our new cap and we got our new coil. Now, there shouldn't be any reason why this motor wouldn't bust off. So let's give it a go here. And excuse my glorious mess, this is the work truck. Well, I hope you found value in this video. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe. It lets YouTube know that this is good content. Until next time, guys, y'all be safe.